Hi everyone, so we are going to talk about the coin change problem and we are going to see the implementation now. And we saw one example that if n is 15 and you have these coins, you want to count the number of ways, count the minimum coins that would be needed to make the change, right? So we also saw that if you have a large problem, you have a large denomination, we will reduce it to sub problems, right? From n, we are going to make a call on n minus coins of 1. Basically, we will say, okay, sub problem will compute how many coins are needed to make a denomination of 14, and then we can pick a 1 rupee coin to make it 15. Or we can say, okay, sub problem will have a look at how to make a 8 and how to make a 5, and we will pick one more coin of 7 rupees to make it 15. Or sub problem will see how to make 5 rupees and we will pick a 10 rupee coin to make 15 rupees, right? So this is what we have done, and we have seen that dp of n is going to be, and let's say it takes x coins, y coins, and it takes z coins. So your answer is going to be minimum of x, y, z, and whatever it is plus 1, because you need one more coin on the top of it, right? So we can write it as it would be minimum for all I dp of n minus coins of I. So this is going, we are going to loop over it, so n minus coins of I. Whatever is the minimum, we will add a 1 here to get the minimum number of coins, right? So we are going to see how we can implement this in a top down manner first. And then we are going to see how we can implement the same in a bottom up manner, right? So I would suggest you to also give it a try by yourself, and you would be able to do this one, right? So minimum coins is the problem. So let me start. Okay, so I'm just taking one example. Let's say n is 15 and coins have this denomination 1, 7, and 10, and I need to count the minimum coins needed. So we get the n, we get the coins array, and we should also get how many different type of coins are there. Let's say m type of coins are there, or it's a t type of coins are there, and n is the amount, right? So, and we should also get the dp array, right? So let me say, okay, dp of 100 and it is 0. And think about the base case, right? So clearly you can say if you have 0 rupees, you need 0 coins. So if n is 0, your answer is going to be 0. For all non-zero answers, you need to have a recursive case which computes how many coins would be needed for a given n, right? And so let us iterate over this coins array, right? So we can say, okay, answer is not known to us. Let's say answer is int max, and we are going to say, okay, for int I equals to 0, I less than t, I plus plus, and here I can say my answer is going to be minimum of whatever is my current answer, whatever I have computed so far, right? Now you have, in the earlier problem, you have to only take minimum of 3 elements. Now here you have to take minimum of lot of options, right? So you have, this array can have a large size also. So if you want to consider the minimum, right? So I'm just taking one variable called answer, which is infinity. And I say, okay, if infinity is minimum or this answer x is minimum, so I make it as x. Then I say if x is minimum or y is minimum, let's say y is minimum, then I make it as y. If y z is minimum, then I make it as z, otherwise it remains as y. So it is just like taking minimum of n possible options, right? So answer is going to be minimum of answer, and what is my current answer, right? So the answer for my sub problem, it would be minimum coins. I will make a recursive call, and my amount would be reduced, so it would be n minus coins of I. if I pick one coin whose value is coins of I, then my sub problem amount would be n minus coins of I, and I will give the coins array, I will give t, and I will also give the dp array. But this can be done only if n minus coins of I is greater than equal to 0, which means the current coin is less than equal to the value of n. For example, if you want to make 5 rupees, then you cannot pick a coin whose denomination is 10 rupees. So this constraint is going to ensure that you do not pick very large coins which are even bigger than n, right? Only in those cases you will compute the sub problem and you will update your answer as sub problem, right? Sub problem answer plus 1, right? So this is what you are going to do, or you can add a 1 here, right? So that's it. And finally, dp of n is going to be equal to answer, and you can say okay, return dp of n. And here you will have a case to look up if a particular state is already computed. So if dp of n is not 0, which means we have already computed for this given state, I'm going to say return dp of n. That's it. And let us try to run this code. So number of types of coins is going to be size of coins array divided by size of int. So you do cout minimum coins, you pass in the value of n, you pass in coins, you pass in t and the dp array. That's it. So C limits. So you can see the answer is 3. If you want to make 15 rupees, your answer is going to be 3, and that we have already seen how it is going to happen, right? So 15 is going to make a call on 14, 14 is going to make a call on 7, and this is going to make a call on 0. So 0 returns 0, 7 returns 1, 14 returns 2, and 15 will return 3, right? After comparing with this, 8 will also return 2, right? And 5 will return 5. So the minimum of 2, 2 and 5 is 2. So your answer is going to be 3. This is how we are going to solve this problem, right? So in the for loop, we have done nothing, but we have just made a call on all possible sub problems, right? So this is what we are doing, and we are taking a minimum at every step, right? And your answer to the current problem would be the answer to the sub problem plus 1, right? So this is how we have implemented the top down solution. In the next part, we will also see how we can implement the bottom up solution.